see you soon.
Stage 9 of the Telefonica Dakar 2003, and it was flat out riding. But problems once more for Spain's Nani Roma. What does he have to do to get to the finish of one of these Dakar rallies? And would you believe it, the old fox is back. Ari Vatanen last won a stage in 96, and he's won another. Okay, let's just have a quick look back to last night in the bivouac. Kenjiro Shinazuka airlifted away and immediately going up to Tunis in the aeroplane. But good news, he's no longer on a ventilator for breathing and is slowly regaining consciousness. Patrick Zanaroli saying it was a very quick section between some dunes and the car jumped very, very quickly. We found the point of impact some 80 meters away from the crest of the dune, so as you can imagine, the force of the impact was enormous.
This is motorsport, and we are really hoping that Shino is all right. That is the main thing, that is the most important thing, but no difference to the way we planned the event. We must carry on.
Meanwhile, yesterday morning at the bivouac at Sabah, not only was some awakening to another perfect day in the Libyan desert, but the road was long for many other people because they were only just arriving from the previous day's stage from Gadames. Other people were having similar accidents to that that befell Shinazuka. How high is a dune like that when you go over the end?
T'es dans la voiture, tout est sans dessus dessous et tu peux pas sortir de la voiture.
You're in the car, he says, you're upside down and you just can't get out. It's terrible with the small windows. You can't get out, and at the same time you feel the fuel dripping onto you. So you have to kill the master switch for the electrics and get out very, very quickly. How steep is that dune? It was a bit close elsewhere. About 2 foot there, I reckon.
Wait 5 minutes, okay?
5 minutes.
They had to help each other out. It was just choking the sand. And whilst they got one of the vehicles out, they then used the other two to get the remaining one out. Team effort all the way. Motorcycles are next up as the Dakar rally continues through the desert of Libya. So today's stage from Sabah to Zilla, right bang slap in the middle of Libya. Short road section, but look at that, 351 miles of competitive stage, and then a short road section at the end. Welcome to our continual coverage here on Speed of the Dakar 2003, and once more Libya beckons. I'm here at Zilla awaiting all of the competitors to arrive after another enormous stage of some 500 kilometres in the greater scheme of things. However, late last night I caught up with Canada's Sean Price. I was watching on the boards and I saw that you had a problem. I didn't want to wake you up this morning because we left before you did, and it was late last night, so you'd probably got in after I disappeared last night. So what happened yesterday?
I appreciate it. Yesterday after about kilometer 100, my cooling system, the fans that cool the radiator system, stopped functioning. And in the deep sand, when you're going through it, just it would overheat. So I'd go about a kilometer, 2 kilometers, have to stop, And as soon as I got some momentum, I could go. But in the sand, it was really treacherous. I thought it was over for sure. And then a guy from the UK, actually, by the name of Nick, he helped me hot wire it to the battery. And there's great camaraderie here. You know, I stopped, helped a guy with gas. He helped me. And we finished last night, I think, around 2 in the morning at night in the dark. It was pretty amazing. It was the real Dakar. It was really something.
What's your impressions of the Dakar? You're a first-timer. What's hit you?
Oh, it's been an incredible experience from a number of perspectives. I think, you know, first and foremost, the people have been outstanding in all aspects. Everyone's been super willing to help. You know, there's a lot to master when you don't work with a road book and a GPS system and an odometer and navigate while you drive. There's a tremendous amount to actually learn. And the people have been incredible supporting that learning curve.
Good to hear and see that Sean is on good form. He's doing very, very well indeed for a rookie. However, what about the guys at the front? Let's catch up with all of those blue, quick KTMs. Frenchman Alain Duclos lost his rear brake yesterday, but we're on board with him today. What do you think of the stage, asks the man in the helicopter. He says, well, first of all, not to fall because it's fast and I'm doing well over 140 kilometres an hour, but I'm not flat out. In order, though, to keep my tyres in good condition, I'm just holding back a little. We're on a stony road. I feel all the bumps and my tyres are beginning to soften up a little. All I want to do is to keep my overall position and not to fall off. Just on the bubble of the top 10. Meanwhile, Giovanni Sala was first on the road by virtue of winning yesterday. The first part of the stage was very, very fast and he used the V-twin power to come through. However, it all went wrong once the rock started. He completely destroyed his rear tyre and he'd lost 2.5 hours. Nanni Roma went over the bars at well over 120 clicks today. He went through some dust to pass another rider, and he's out. The doctor here saying he's injured his back. Not too bad, but it's his vertebra. He's all right. He's stable, but he's in a little bit of pain. Roma will go to Cairo tomorrow and then on to Spain. And after 6 years as a works rider, he's out of this Dakar once more. I think it was a right kink at 140, 150 kilometers an hour, and a stone was there, it threw me off, it was a big stone. I rolled over and I hurt myself very badly. Out there in the desert, it may have been barren, but speed was to be the essence of the day. If you're quick, you're alive. Richard Sanks, he fell in the early part of today's 350-mile stage. He fell, he twisted the forks of the machine, but fortunately at the refueling, his teammates helped him to repair the machine. Sank, though, was victorious, taking just over 6 hours to complete the stage. Now, Mione lost 6 minutes after arriving at Roma's accident to help out his teammate. Mione was second on the stage, and he's second overall by just over a minute. De Azevedo, third in today's stage, only losing 5 minutes to Sank. Cyril Depre, another water carrier, he was fourth today. And in the latter half of the stage, as you can see, stuck in this crater. But he likes trial riding, and he didn't put a foot down. He's now on the virtual podium. Meanwhile, Jean Brusi was having trouble in the same area. Fifth on the stage was Brusi. He's fourth overall. Brilliant job from the Frenchman. Big tall Marc Coma from Spain stayed with Nanni Roma until the medical crews arrived, so he lost a bit of time. However, he still finished in sixth position, only losing 17 minutes. What could he have done without his teammates' misfortune? Francois Flick, number 22, jumping for joy. 7th on the stage today. 8th overall. Another superb job. And from Norway, Per Anders Ulvaeseter in 8th position on the stage. 7th overall for Scandinavia. Carlo Di Gavardo, 9th today. But he's in 6th overall and continuing to improve with that injured left wrist. Mitsuhashi, 10th today, the leading non-KTM with his Honda XR650. He's 13th overall for Japan. So Sankt victorious once more ahead of Mioni just to Azevedo from Brazil, Depre and Brucey for France. Overall though, Richard Sankt has got the lead by a mere 1:10 from Mioni, Depre, Brucey and De Azevedo. KTM's all the way through.
J'ai fait une chute
sur la première partie et puis j'avais
la moto qui était un
peu tordue et la deuxième partie a dû la rouler.
Donc je suis resté derrière
Fabrizio et
è una giornata che non è cominciata bene. Dopo 130 km c'era il
programma del day was a stage of more than 500 km, but in the first part I saw Roma and had a big crash.
Paura per lui che si fosse fatto male.
I stopped and pulled his valise.
Poi invece sono stato lì qualche minuto con
and
lui.
I stayed quite a while with him, but happily though cose, he was okay. He was hurt, but not too seriously.
La Dakar per lui è veramente sfortunata.
After that, I continued on my way. Sala here said that the moose in my tire was completely destroyed at 210 clicks. I recovered some of the time. And then another biker gave me a repair kit to the finish to get me to the finish, but I was obliged to finish the stage very slowly to be sure that I arrived here in the bivouac. As you can see, it's seen better days. Stay tuned, tricky navigation challenges the competitors on stage 9 of the Dakar Rally. Can you believe it? January the 14th, 1996 was the last time that Finland's Ari Vatanen won a stage, and he's done it again today. Well done for the Nissan squad to bring them their fortunes a little higher after the terrible misfortune that befell Kenjiro Shinazuka yesterday. Ari Vatanen in control for Finland. Well, he may be getting a little older, but the speed is still there. The spectators looked on curiously. And their view was of a perfect Mitsubishi formation flying duo. Petter Hansel said he was driving slower and safer, whereas Hiroshi Mashiwoka said, well, maybe I was driving a bit quicker. Be the judge of it yourself. However, as Petter Hansel sped away towards us, Mashiwoka running into problems, a puncture for the reigning Dakar champion, and he had to stop and change it with his German co-driver, Andreas Schulz. Now, Mashiwoka had already taken avoiding action early in the stage to avoid a motorcyclist who nearly ran into the Mitsubishi, and maybe this was the cause of running over some rocks. Fontenay, though, was the man who arrived upon the scene to assist Hiroshi Mashiwoka. But eventually, Mashiwoka had a total of 5 punctures in the stage. He also had another one on the road section of only 12 kilometres into the bivouac here in Zilla this evening. Mashiwoka was driving bravely through the dust, and at times he had to take the risk to just get ahead of former winner Jean-Pierre Fontenay. It was risky stuff. Meanwhile, Petter Hansel was just banging away in the lead, just taking the time. Petter Hansel getting time over Mashiwoka today. Once more, Mashiwoka running right off the carcass of the tyre, right down to the rim, and Fontenay as dutifully as ever arriving with more tyres. Remember that they only start with 3 spares in the back of the Mitsubishis. So when Mashuoka had had a total of 5, he had to call on other people for more. Greg Wadamavius was not without problems himself. 2 punctures, and also he was sick and tired of seeing all of those volcanic rocks. He was 4th on the stage today. Only 2.5 minutes, mind, back up at Hansel. Demavius changing the tyre, whilst co-driver Alain was working the jack. Remember that this is the best we have seen a diesel car in the Dakar throughout its 25-year history. Good job that Sven Kvaerts has done with that 2-car squad. Well, we haven't seen a Schlesser buggy for a while because there's only one of them left in the rally. Jose Maria Servia with the new 3-litre Ford V6 was 5th today. Another buggy, but this time a 1.9 turbo diesel 4-cylinder, is that of Jutta Kleinschmitz. She was 6th on stage today, still a little hamstrung with outright top speed, but she does make the time back up through the dunes. It's half the weight, this car, of the BMW. And never mind weight, never mind technical talk, sometimes people just get lost. Luke Alphon, having lost nearly 7 hours a couple of days ago with a suspension problem when he hit a rock, certainly had the speed on de Villiers, but it wasn't really a fair race. De Villiers losing an enormous amount of time today because a rear track rod arm had broken, and he had to complete the last part of the stage at about 80 kilometers an hour. What a shame for the South African. Stefan Orard with Belfast's Bobby Willis had time to wave and time to say it was boring. Vatanen back at the top of the tables. Isn't that good to see? Ahead of Fontenay, Peder Hansel, Demavius and Servia. However, in the overall standings, it's now nearly 17 minutes between the two Mitsubishi Pajeros. Demavius there in third, Kleinschmidt and Souza.
No, tänään alkoi päivä loistavasti, kun kuulin...
Ari Vatanen saying this morning, we had good news about Kenjiro Shinazuka's condition, and I was very happy when I arrived at the start of the stage. I took happiness from driving today, as I like to drive very fast. Even at the end of the stage, it was just like it is in the Thousand Lakes back home in Finland, and even after the flying finish, I had time to do a donut before the stop line. I enjoyed that, because there were lots of people there that enjoyed it. And their applause made me smile. It's a sort of happiness between people. And it was celebrating the fact that Shino is beginning to feel better.
En malttanut olla ajamatta sen täysillä vielä. Annan mennä auto ihan poikittain. Ja kansa taputti sen, että hyvä, että saan pysähtymään auton siihen ajanottoteltalle. Mutta semmoista se on, kun nauttii.
A
good day today, apart from the 2 wheels we had to give to Mashuoka. Gilles Picard, my co-driver, didn't make any mistakes, and I'm very satisfied. However, my thoughts are with Shinazuka and my friend Thierry Delizotti. I'm very concerned by what happened to them yesterday, and I want to let them know that they must hang on until better moments. When we return, the Dakar continues from Sabah to Zilla. Trucks, as always, have been bashing the roads out there today en route to Zilla. In the end, it was the youngster, Gerardus de Roy, who was eventually quickest over the stage ahead of Khabirov, ahead of Azevedo and Chagin. However, Gerardus, who was victorious, was not without problems throughout the stage. They smelt some oil at one particular point, but came to the conclusion that it was just one of the shock absorbers leaking. And to give you an idea of how quick the stage was at the beginning, they did the first 300 kilometers, 180 miles, in 2.5 hours. And then they did the last 120 miles, 200 kilometers, in 4.5 hours. that was how difficult and rocky it was towards the end of today's stage. In the overall standings, though, Gerardus, son of Johan, is leading overall ahead of Vladimir Chagin, who had a puncture today. De Azevedo for Brazil is third in the overall standings. And Johan de Roy, the master of the 1200 horsepower truck that we saw in the clip earlier from back in the middle 80s, is in fourth position with his hybrid DAF truck. De Azevedo in the Tatra. Let us not forget that Loprace is out of the rally after an enormous roll a couple of days ago. Sugawara, former victor, in his all-Japanese Hino, is in sixth position overall. So what have we got tomorrow? Well, we're going from Zilla to Sarria. It's a stage of 521 kilometres. That's well over 300 miles. Bang slap in the middle of nowhere before a short road section before arriving in the bivouac. So the end of another difficult day on this year's Dakar. We're here at Zilla and we've just had a very, very dusty sandstorm come over our heads. It's quite windy, as you can see behind me with that flag nearly bent over double, but not too much dust at the moment. It's going to be a very uncomfortable night for many, but certainly maybe not Stefan Pedersen, who's extended his overall lead with his Mitsubishi Pajero. What can Hiroshi Mashuoka do tomorrow as we continue further into Libya, when it's going to get maybe even warmer, even dustier, but certainly even harder, that is for sure. Still a long way to go on this year's event, and remember that you can see all of the action here on Speed right to the end on January the 19th.